Hello everybody, my name is Phoebe Kunduri. I'm a professor of economics at the Athens University of Economics and Business, and I am very happy to welcome you to Climathon Greece. I am here as the coordinator of Climate Kick Hub Greece, and very happy to be welcoming the Climathons of Athens, Piraeus, Larissa, and Crete. Climathons are important initiatives that try to raise awareness about climate change and climate action, and also mobilize technical expertise in terms of implementing hackathons, gathering data, gathering information tools that can enable climate action. Let me first give you a bit of background on Climate Kick. What does a kick do? A kick, the European Climate Kick and the Greek Climate Kick focus on convening networks of expertise, leveraging grants smartly and efficiently, developing people and capacity, and catalyzing innovation. And a climate kick is trying to do that in order to mobilize solutions for mitigating and adapting to climate change. The European Climate Kick has been very successful throughout the years of its existence. It has identified more than 300 leading partners, more than 550 million in investments in startups, more than 1,000 startups, more than 2.5 billion in climate financing, and more than 17,000 of participants. So it's a strong initiative, it can mobilize action, and it is important to have our climathons under the climate kick in order to merge the power of a kick with the power of the climathon. I'm also here as in my capacity as co-chair of the Sustainable Development Solutions Network of Greece. I am co-chairing this network with Professor Andreas Papandreou, who will also be talking to you. The idea of this network is that we want to globally bring together innovation solutions, science-driven innovation solutions for our problems with regards to making our life sustainable. The Sustainable Development Solutions Network is under the auspices of the General Secretary of the United Nations, and it tries to bridge the gap, increase the communication between the researchers and the scientists and the academic networks that produce technological and social solutions for sustainable development, and give these solutions to business, to the civil society, to policymakers and politicians, and incentivize them to implement these solutions. So the Sustainable Development Solutions Network is a global movement that can be enforced by the work of a climate kick, because the climate kick is doing exactly that, identifying the technological and also social innovations in order to accelerate investment in climate adaptation and mitigation solutions. And what you are all doing, what you all gathered to do, is very important and very relevant to that, because you have each a challenge, each town has a challenge. One challenge refers to a tree inventory, challenge of the municipality of Piraeus refers to fishing plastic from our marine resources and reusing this plastic, and in this way cleaning our marine resources and enabling a sustainable use of these marine resources. And also Larissa and Crete have more general sustainability relevant climate adaptation and mitigation processes. So what we are doing today is very important. Why? We all know, or at least we should all know, and if we don't, this is scary, we should know that a few weeks ago, the Intergovernmental Policy Panel on Climate Change issued a new report that says that it's not enough to keep world temperature below 2 degrees as it compares to pre-industrial levels. It is important to keep it below 1.5 degrees Celsius. So the increase in average world temperature should be kept below 1.5. Otherwise, in 12 years, only 12 years, most of us will be alive by then. So in 20 years, if we don't manage these targets, if we don't achieve this target, we will be facing irreversible catastrophic events as societies, as countries, as communities, as humanity as a whole. So the urgency is clear. The scientific evidence are clear. The technology to do so exists. We already have the technology to reduce, to keep climate change below 1.5 Celsius. What we need is to mobilize all the relevant communities and get the civil society, policymakers and politicians on board in order to enable the implementation of the technological and social solutions that will allow us to live in this planet as we live today in the near future. So sustainability, when I first started teaching sustainability, we were referring to sustainability as an organizing principle that allows the natural capital to be sustained in such a way that people can use natural resources and ecosystem services that derive from them in a way that they can meet their own needs today and the next generation can meet their needs as well. So the next generation should not compromise their ability to meet their needs. And this principle has environmental dimensions. We have to sustainably manage our natural resources and achieve ecosystem resilience. It has economic implications. We have to have financial and economic sustainability over time and across countries. And we also need to have the social dimension of the sustainability principle. That is, we need to have in a society intra and intergenerational equity. Nowadays, we need sustainability. We need the environmental, the economic, the social aspect of sustainability, but not anymore to keep the next generation safe. We need to do it in order to keep our lives safe. We only have 12 years. So as soon as we realize this, as soon this becomes a message that the society understands and engages with, as soon all the different stakeholders, not just the scientists who know the scientific facts, not just the technology inventors who have spent their lives producing technologies that can be implemented to reverse climate change, but also the civil society, everybody from kindergarten to the university, to our grandparents, the policymaking people and the politicians need to engage in this, be convinced of the urgency of the matter, and really support initiatives that try to keep temperature below 1.5 as soon as possible. We have the money to do it. We have the means, the technology to do it. We need the engagement. And it is very difficult to achieve engagement when you are dealing with natural resources. Why? Because you don't have explicit property rights. So everybody can use them. Everybody has access to them, but they don't need to pay anything in order to consume it, in order to use it, in order to engage with the ecosystem services of a natural resource. This creates the known in economics free-rided problem, and this leads to the tragedy of the commons. And it is a real tragedy because if you don't manage to optimally use your resources over time and space, you will end up in a real tragedy where you destroy the planet in which you live and in which your children and grandchildren are supposed to live. So the message is important. The economists are important in supporting this implementation and acceleration effort for solutions for climate change, because the economists can do the exercise in identifying the social benefits and the social costs of different actions, different interventions. And interventions can be an infrastructural intervention, it can be an economic instrument intervention, it can be a nature-based solution, it can be a social awareness campaign, and so on. So economists can tell you how you can incentivize climate relevant behavior, sustainable behavior with regards to climate change. It can make people change their behavior towards saving the planet. And economists need information technology to do that, because we need the data to analyze the behavior of the ecosystem and the behavior of the people. We basically analyze the interaction, the dynamic interaction between nature and people, and through this analysis we identify ways that can make this interaction sustainable. So what is being done today? Exercises on gathering data, collecting data, analyzing data, using data to incentivize solutions for problems is hugely important. And one last thing that is hugely important and is coming out of today's climathons over Greece and all over the world is the huge impact on awareness and possibly engagement of the relevant stakeholders, who are not just the policymakers or just the business people or just the scientists. It's everybody. It's a very holistic exercise, and unless we have quick engagement, we are going to fail. And we are going to fail badly, and we are going to fail irreversibly. So we are here not to fail. We have the young people supporting this exercise. We have the scientists and the academic community supporting this exercise. We have the municipal authorities supporting this exercise. And we are going to bring more on board as we proceed with making climate innovation, climate action. I want to close my speech by saying that what will happen in the next 2 years is in the hands of each and every one of us, and each and every one of us should use its own means, understanding, education, network, in order to mobilize enough resources in order to avoid catastrophic events. Let's say a good message out of all this is the signal from the international academic community that in 2018, the Nobel Prize in Economics has been given to economists that dealt with integrating in microeconomic models climate change, that is William Nordhaus, and technological innovation, that is Romer. So finally, the international scientific community has recognized the importance of integrating economics, and in this way, engaging the stakeholder and incentivize them towards sustainability behavior towards climate. And this recognition, I hope, will further empower our struggle with engaging all relevant stakeholders. Good luck, good work. Thank you for being here. Thank you to the organizers of Climathon, Eleni Petra and her team. Thank you to Climate Kick Greece and Climate Kick Euros. Thank you.